Good day, everyone. Today, I am at Chillventa in Nuremberg 2024 at the Danfoss booth. And I would like to have an opportunity to talk about the latest innovations in technology for industrial refrigeration. And with me, we have my guest, Benoit Rodier. Benoit, please introduce yourself.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Hernan. I'm Benoit Rodier from Cimco Refrigeration. I'm the Director of Business Development, and I'm also running our decarbonization booth. I've been with the company 25 years, and Hernan has been a very important supplier of our company for the past 20, 30 years, if not less.
Thank you, Benoit. And my name is Hernan Hidalgo. I'm the Director of Business Development for Industrial Refrigeration in North America. So let's get started. Benoit, one of the major challenges that our industry has been facing for the last 5-10 years?
It's an excellent question, Hernan. As everybody knows, today we're moving towards decarbonizing our industry. There's two challenges we're facing, is reduce fossil fuel usage, but at the same time, we're trying to reduce electrical consumption as well. We like to focus on natural refrigerant like ammonia, but we're also trying to improve the usage of this excellent industrial system. Danfoss is bringing new solution to the market, and I think it's really interesting because it benefits both the contractor and the customer as well.
Thank you, Benoit. So let me address, I think we accepted the challenge, and I would like to introduce what we believe is a game changer in the industry. So let me start by explaining how this thing works. In our industry, there are basically two types of systems. We have DX systems, and we have recirculated systems. And both have some challenges too. On the DX systems, obviously we reduce the ammonia charge, but there is a component which is the excessive energy consumption that they may bring because there is superheat. And that superheat translates into the higher energy consumption that is anywhere between 10 to 20%. So how do we address this? So we have a technology that has a panel with a control system that has machine learning algorithms that couple with pressure and temperature sensors and the newly developed sensor. This sensor is basically the key along with machine learning algorithm that allow us to completely remove the superheat down to zero. And in that way, the energy consumption could be reduced anywhere between 10 to 20% in system. If it's a recirculated system, then the energy efficiency could be probably 2 to 3%. But the main benefit is that the ammonia charge that you may have at any given find would be reduced by 40%. That means that if you have a 10,000 pounds of ammonia system or refrigerant system, you can run it with 4,000 pounds, 6,000 pounds, reducing 4,000 pounds. That's remarkable. The technology, basically, it's available today also with the help of a motorized valve. The controller basically modulates the motorized valve with the new actuator ICAT 600B, which has a much higher resolution on the one hand, but is also fully connected via Bluetooth and Modbus connectivity. So with all this in place, now we can safely basically bring the challenge that we have basically to a real formal solution that is available to the industry. In terms of the industry, what benefits do you think that you can see a lot of benefits to end users as well?
There's multiple benefits that we can see. The first benefit, of course, is the electrical consumption, which is a saving. The second benefit, of course, is also increasing the safety of the installation. We know that using a very efficient refrigerant like ammonia, we also have to deal with refrigerant charge, as you mentioned before. With your technology, reducing the ammonia charge also has a financial impact on the customer because the safety requirement, the PSM plan, as an example, is also a critical part of the entire operation of the customer. Reducing the charge, reduce the investment, the safety requirement, and we still have a performing installation.
And it's very good that you bring that point because when you look at the financial impact savings for the end users, if we take an example, a very average installation of cold storage installation, 300,000 square feet that runs and probably plus 20 and minus 20 with a 10 to 15 cents a kilowatt hour of price of energy, we can actually see anywhere between $150,000 to $225,000 of the savings every year. That is also coupled with the amount of CO2 reduction that we have. For that specific example, we could have anywhere between 400 to 500 metric tons of CO2 reduction altogether. So we are very happy to be here today to provide that technology to the industry and have our farmers looking forward to working with us and continue solving the challenges of our industry. Thank you very much, Benoit.
It's a pleasure. Thank you very much.